Hello, everybody, and welcome to another episode of New Game Play. Today, I'm Kyle Hilliard, here with Charles Harte.
Hello, what's up?
I panicked for a moment because I was like, I know your last name at this point, but I was like, I paused. I was like, Harte, right?
Mm-hmm,
yeah, so
mm-hmm.
I did it. Aren't you proud of me?
It's got the E on the end, which throws people off, so.
It's not Harte, huh? Mm-hmm. But, okay, so we are looking at Crisis Core Final Fantasy VII Reunion, which is a confusing title. It's a remake of a PSP game, which I only dabbled with a little bit back in the day. Did you ever play it, Charles?
No, I didn't have. I wasn't a PSP kid.
Okay. So this is a prequel to Final Fantasy VII, and I'm kind of in this weird zone where I've played Final Fantasy VII. A little bit, like the original PlayStation 1 game. I played it, you know, I've had a couple of starts and stops with that game where I would play it and then not finish it and come back a couple years later and stuff like that. So I'm not a super fan by any means. And then I played Final Fantasy VII Remake in full and really enjoyed it. Talked about my experience with it in depth over at MinMax, which you can check out. And then now this is a remake of a PSP game, which I already established, I think, and it's a prequel to Final Fantasy VII proper, where you play as Zack.
Can I ask, is the PSP game also like an action game like this?
Yes.
Okay.
So it's interesting because, like, you'll see this is like a pre-rendered cutscene. This is taken from the PSP game. Like, I think they, you know, up-resed it a little bit, but it actually looks weirdly kind of rough compared to the gameplay now, which is a strange way that works, where, like, this actually, I would argue, looks stronger and better than the pre-rendered cutscenes in the game at this point. It's a weird thing, because what they did is they didn't remake any of those pre-rendered cutscenes, but they did remake, you know, all the gameplay. The combat's been overhauled, the visuals have been overhauled, and that kind of thing. It's a nice, you know, 60 FPS action game now. But it does play differently from Final Fantasy VII Remake, even if it kind of looks like Final Fantasy VII Remake, if that makes sense.
Yeah, I was going to mention that. I also was going to ask about the slot machine in the upper left-hand corner.
Yeah, so that thing's kind of always going, and then it gives you different bonuses depending on where it lands. And depending on how you're doing, you can dictate a little bit of, you know, who shows up more, and you can actually improve the relationships with those characters that you're seeing in there to, you know, make them more powerful when they show up and stuff like that. It's a weird system. In fact, I don't know if I like it. But
it definitely has like the RPG syndrome of, like, as someone who hasn't played any of this game, I'm looking at it and I can tell there's a lot of systems going on right now that I haven't seen the tutorials for, or I don't really understand it, but it's still like flashy and entertaining in a specific way.
Yeah, well, it's interesting because, like, I quickly kind of started ignoring it, honestly, because it's just like bonus, right? It's like, oh, cool, I got something from that. Neat.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just going to focus on hitting this robot with my sword. I summoned Ifrit here twice. Is that Ifrit? I think so. Conflict resolved. But it's interesting. It's it looks good. It looks like Final Fantasy VII Remake, but there's still, like, you can kind of feel the PSP bones on this thing, if that makes sense. Right? Like, you're just kind of moving from encounter to encounter. And it's interesting. I'm working on the review. We'll have the review up, you know, in time for the embargo, hopefully, and that kind of thing. But I wanted to show it off a little bit. This is in the second chapter of the game.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm working with Tsang here to do some research. It's interesting because, like, I am kind of new to the Final Fantasy VII larger story. And, you know, I could very easily go, you know, read the Wikipedia plot summary of this game since it's a remake, but I'm not, because it's kind of like, oh, you know, I'm playing Remake. I'm kind of on that treadmill, so to speak. Now I've committed at this point. You know, I played through the first one. I'm going to play the follow-ups. So I'm kind of taking this, as if I were experiencing, you know, the story for the first time, which I am.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
I imagine maybe some people are in the same boat as me, so I won't even try to, you know, I can tell you this is Zach, and I know he has some kind of relationship with Cloud, but I don't want to go into it any further than that.
Yeah, I am fascinated by the way Final Fantasy does the, like, circular, you know, remake slash new series games. Like, I know Final Fantasy VII Remake, which I played some of but didn't finish. I know it's different than the original game. And it's
significantly, yeah, both in story and gameplay.
Yeah, I'm in story specifically, as I was talking about here, but I am wondering if that will affect this. I don't know if your experience with the PSP game feels like this is different or if it's a lot more faithful.
Story-wise, it feels faithful because they're really including the pre-rendered cutscenes wholesale.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think there's going to be a radical change in the story by the end of the game. I think the thing that they focused on predominantly was making the gameplay feel closer to 7 Remake.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we're talking about Sephiroth, and Geel is a dude who I was friends with, and now I don't know what he's up to, Charles. He could be up to something.
I really like the name Angeal, because Sephiroth... And again, not knowing anything about Final Fantasy VII, really, it's like a angelic name, so to just kind of it Angeal. Like a person with a Russian accent trying to say the word angel.
Yeah. I didn't even try to argue with him. He's like, "All right, it seems like you got this under control."
I was gonna say those dialogue interactions, like the not quite cutscenes, very very much feel PSP to me.
Yes, it's definitely activate, you know, sad animation when something sad happens, and it's like they're just sort of standing there stiff, exchanging dialogue. But it's a lot of moving through, just like missions like this. They're very short and bite-sized, which I think is, you know, inherited from being a handheld game. They wanted to make all the encounters pretty quick, which I don't mind. It's not something I think is, you know, lacking playing it on a console here. It's like, yeah, I don't mind just beating up a couple dudes and moving on. That's great. Let's do that.
Do you have an idea of, like, how long it is?
So the PSP game was, like, about 20 to 50 hours, you know, depending on how much of a completionist you were. But I think you can get through the story in about 20 hours.
Cool.
But that's assuming there aren't any, you know, huge surprise changes in the late game, which would be a surprise in itself. If that happened and it was like, you know, this is way different than the original PSP game, I would be surprised.
Mm-hmm.
I also feel really bad for this game being the action game that I'm playing immediately after God of War Ragnarok. Sorry about that timing, Final Fantasy. Not much I can do for you there. Mm-hmm. But it looks good. It's just simple.
Yeah.
Which isn't, you know, a knock against the game necessarily. It is just strange how, you know, all in they're going on these, on the, bring, you know, redoing Final Fantasy VII all the way through.
Yeah.
It's such a strange thing.
It was a thing of, you know, not to say it was like Half-Life 3 levels of internet hype, but like the concept of remaking Final Fantasy VII was such like a exciting premise, I think, to a lot of people, and they really took it and they're like, okay, well, if you want it, we're gonna really, really, really milk this out. And I'm kind of into it. I think it's... I appreciate commitment out of a game dev.
Bringing it to a new generation here. Oh, I got three looks like clouds. I guess I don't know who it is, really. But see, that's an example of just, like, the roulette, like, giving me something cool. It's like, all right, yeah, I'll take advantage of that. Sure, why not? I don't have an electric attack. I have Blizzard. See, I can do fire here. And I can do Blizzard. And I have Cure as well. But usually there's a little icon above their head that'll be like, oh, this guy's weak to fire. Throw some fire at him, you know. These robots, if you will, just have a an attack that I don't have yet, because this is only chapter 2. We're only allowed to show up to chapter 3.
Mm-hmm.
And it's funny. Like I said, this is a remake, but I feel like there are people who are probably wanting to avoid spoilers.
Yeah, I get it.
Because I played 7 Remake for the first time.
This is where the copies are made.
Yeah, we'll finish out this cutscene here. Genesis. Look at that computer. Jeez, that looks like a...
That's how you know the year it's from.
A product of the era it was made. Good lord. Jeez. That's just like, dude, you're getting a Dell right there. I want to look at that thing. Let's see. Wow.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Cool computer, man. But, yeah, so, like, the other thing is, you know, I can save, obviously. Not a revolutionary mechanic there. But here you can also access, like, missions. And these are just, like, you know, I can jump into these at any time, mm-hmm. you know. Which, to me, feels very much of that era of, like, PSP.
Because
that was, like, a big thing for, like, Metal Gear, Peace Walker, and stuff like that. It was, like, you could just kind of... You just have tons of missions that you could go do, mm-hmm. you know? Like, it's just, like, it's a means to, like, hey, we made this, like, cool combat, and here's a bunch of missions you can go do at your own leisure. They're all pretty short. Have mm-hmm. a good time.
Do you think it translates as well to, like, the PS5? Is this just on PS5 or is it also PS4?
PS4 as well.
Gotcha.
Yeah. It's fine. It's like, I do wonder if somebody played this without the knowledge of knowing that it was a former PSP game, mm-hmm. if they would question it. And they'd be like, oh, it's weird how this is structured. Mm-hmm. I don't think they would, honestly. All right, so this guy, the Foul... What is that? Foulander C. He's got the little Blizzard logo above his head. Let's get out of here. And so I can... So he's weak to that. See, weakened.
Gotcha.
Very simple. It's not even... You don't even have to do the math in your head of like, oh, he has ice over his head, so I should probably throw fire at him. It's like, this guy has ice over his head. Throw ice at him.
Mm-hmm. Do you have to learn that, or is this kind of come with every...
It's part of the tutorial, gotcha. You know. So, like, that was a mission, right? I just, like, went... I'm in the middle of this story mission. He's... I don't know what he's, like... He's looking up Ask Jeeves questions or something. And, like, I just went and knocked out that mission. And that's kind of the structure of the game. It's just a bunch of, like, quick missions with pretty solid combat.
Mm-hmm.
You know? It's pretty flashy. This is, when it comes to, like, Final Fantasy VII spinoffs, I think, generally speaking, this is considered to be the best one, right? Like, there's the Dirge of Cerberus and stuff like that, which I know people are not huge fans of. And, you know, there's a few others. And then 7 Remake is a big deal. And then Crisis Core was the one, the lingering one, that's like, you know what? That one's pretty good. That one's worth playing if you want more Final Fantasy VII, even though it's an action game as opposed to an RPG. But yeah, I think that's a pretty good look at... All right, let me see if I can get the name right again. Crisis Core Final Fantasy VII Reunion. I think that's how they're properly...
Yes,
explaining it. Yes. It, apparently, according to this website, Charles, it has broken the limits of an HD remaster.
Whoa.
So, get ready for that.
I'm excited to see the future of HD remasters, now that they've broken the limits.
I guess that's a pun, right? Because you can do limit breaks in the game. I guess that's what they're going for. But, yeah, it comes out on PS5 and PS4 on December 13th, and we should have a review up pretty soon. I'm excited to keep playing and sort of be part of this, like, new generation of Final Fantasy VII. It's a weird place to be.